of ECG machines, try to get insight on that as well. What are the problems you can have while getting a right ECG? Every place wouldn't be an ICVD. So remember that you, your patient, an ECG machine, that can happen sometimes. So be careful that you should know yourself how to do ECG. So this is something about very basics. So that's the way you get normal 12 lead ECG. We started with heart, conduction system, leads, paper, and ultimate recording. We can come to question answer later, this recording, everything going on. And in this basics, we have covered access as well. So one portion is covered. Now rhythm analysis. As I told you, that's the most important thing. Rhythm analysis. Rest of the thing in ECG are total recall. Recall means if you know that there are some things you have to look for, you will see them and you will find them. ST elevation, ST depression, LVH, RVH, LA enlargement, RA enlargement. This rhythm is the only thing where you need contemplation. Every other person can have different interpretation of different ECGs for sake of rhythm. That means you have to acquire a basic principle that how to go about in assessing rhythm. That's very important to follow those, that principle. You may do mistakes initially while assessing those things, but subsequently if you go through those steps, you won't miss anything. That's very important. So whenever you're assessing rhythm, let's assess first this rhythm. Can I call anyone to really read this rhythm? What is it? Just quickly tell us, what's the rhythm? 69 years old man without symptoms, what is the rhythm? No mumbling and no like suggestions. Let her decide what's the rhythm. Okay, so what's your conclusion about this rhythm? That this rhythm is, you think it's junctional rhythm. Now this is not a comprehensive assessment. That's the issue. Most of the time when you'll be dealing cardiac patient, you'll found multiple abnormality in a single ECG. So that means you need to be comprehensive in assessing things and look at every facet, and then come up with conclusion. Don't see one thing and just come up with conclusion. That's the important thing. Now can you see these P waves? Isn't it? Apparently it was looking that there isn't any P wave. Dhoondne se khuda bhi mil jata hai. Toh kya hota hai? Jab ek surge, ek aapke andar khud ek surge ho ki mujhe ye cheeze rhythm assessment ke liye chahiye. Then I'll come to conclusion. If you jump on to conclusion just seeing one thing, then you'll do mistakes. And ECG is, the key is lies in comprehensive assessment. Now let's see where you did mistake and why. So this rhythm is actually sinus rhythm with markedly prolonged PR interval. It's not just the sinus. You see PR is prolonged and the QRS is broad with RBB pattern. So multiple thing in single rhythm strip, and that can only be assessed if you see everything comprehensively. That we all know, I already have discussed the normal origin and normal conduction pattern of rhythm. That you have to contemplate. Ye bus, ECG ki bus kahan se shuru hoti hai? So iska starting stop kya hai? SA node. And it goes through the atrias and then stops at AV node. How do you know that? By looking at P wave. and then PR interval, that it stops for a normal duration. Then after a bundle of his, this buzz divides in two portions. One go to the right and one goes to the, and go in both roads it goes at same speed and drop the all musafirs there, and then the next bus start after a specific duration from SA node again. That's the thing you have to remember, the ECG origin and conduction pattern, and we'll see how to look for that in this rhythm assessment that we all know. I'm just quickly going through. Now, principles of rhythm analysis. No matter what the rhythm is looking like, the first step is leave everything aside, broad, narrow, regular, irregular, whatever. First calculate rate. Compel yourself to do these things in these steps. Rate will tell you what to do with your patient. Does your patient needs immediate intervention or you have time? Like rate 20. Now there is not a time to go through ECG and P and PR, whatever. Now go to the patient. Is he stable or? And do appropriate things. Similarly, rate is 180. Time to go to patient. No further assessment needed. What's going on with the patient? That's important. So first thing, rate. Calculate rate. Second, now you have done that this rate is this much. Now look at the QRS complexes. Are they regular or irregular? So this is one of the feature of rhythm. A number of time I ask juniors, what's the rhythm? Sir, ye regular hai. Oh, mere bhai, regular ek rhythm ka feature hai. Rhythm is either sinus, nodal, ventricular tachycardia, AV block. This is rhythm. So this regularity and irregularity is feature of rhythm that need to be assessed as a second step. So in this heading, you have to look for, is it regular, irregular? If irregular, regularly irregular, irregularly irregular, or occasional irregular. There are three things in that. Third, P. Don't ever comment without looking at all the 12 leads whether there are P waves or not. PR interval. Fifth step, QRS duration. Narrow or broad. Whenever someone asks him, what about QRS? Sir, it's normal. There's no normal. QRS is either narrow or wide or broad. Rate calculation, we all know that how to calculate rate, the golden principles of that, one large square, 300, two large, 150, but that will apply to only regular rhythms. In irregular rhythms, what you have to look for, just see a 6 second strip, and we all know that 1 second is 5 large square, isn't it? Then just count 6 seconds and see how many QRS complexes are there in 6 seconds, multiply it with 10. That will be the exact rate of 60 seconds. The 1 minute rate will be multiple of those complexes which are there in 6 seconds. And this formula applies to both regular and irregular rhythm. That formula, which is like this, this applies to regular rhythm. 1 large square, 300, 150. But this formula, looking at a 6 second strip and looking how many QRSs are there, like 6 QRS in 6 seconds, then the rate is 6 multiplied by 10, 5, 50, 7, 70, 8, 80. And how to calculate 6 second strip? By marking every 5 large square afterward, and then you will get the 6 second strip. Now, regularity, just look at every QRS, are they equidistant from each other or not? That you have to look for. RR interval, are they equidistant or not? And that can be done either a caliper or your visual impression, just making an impression that like first QRS is three large and one small. Now just look subsequent, are they exactly three large and one small or not? P, there's something more about P. What you have to look for in P? First, present or? Do the P waves all look alike or not? Now what you have to do really to assess this point, for a transient period of time, assume that there are no QRS and you're looking at P's. What are their own rhythm? Is the P rhythm regular or irregular? So you have to see P rhythm. Then last and very important, is there one P before each QRS or more than one? That's again very important to know, that you have to go through that TP interval very carefully, even within T, and sometime even within ST you may found P. So very carefully look on to the segments, are there any P wave more than the sinus one or not? So these four points are very important. Are there P waves? Do the P look alike or different? Do the P occur at regular rate? Or is there one P before each QRS? That's very important. Then PR interval. That you all know, that normal is 3 small and 5 small. Not more than that and not less than that. QRS duration, narrow or wide? And then again, it should be less than 3 small squares. Now my jobs end here regarding rhythm. Now your job starts. First step in rhythm assessment. It's an interactive ECG basic workshop. So there will be some interaction. Very good. Calculate rate. So what do you think should be the rate here? Roughly. Just come up with. Isn't it? It's around not 70. Because 3 large squares are 100. And this is like one small square more than the 3. So 3 large and 1 small. So it's 95. I can tell you the exact rate calculation by just looking at large and small squares, but provided that your rhythm is regular. Just remember this cue. You won't find it in any of the ECG books. Rate, one large, rate will be 300. One large, one small, rate 270. One large, two small, 240. One large, three small, 210. One large, four small, 180. Two large, 150. Two large, one small, 140. 130, 120, 110, and three large. Three large, one small, 95. Three large, two small, 90. 85, 80. Four large. Four large, one small, 72. Four large, two small, 69. Four large, three small, 65. Well, how I am calculating? There is a formula to that. When you are coming from one large to two large, just reduce 30 for each small square. When you are coming from 2 large to 3 large, just reduce the rate by 10 for each small squares. When you are coming from 3 large to 4 large, just reduce 5 for each small squares. When you are coming from like 4 large to 5 large, 3. From 5 to 6, 2. And this all is contemplated from that standardization calculation. And that's the way. So be master in ECG. Just one glimpse of ECG and everything is there in your mind. This ECG shows this thing. And that's not difficult. That needs a disciplined way of ECG reading and contemplation quick after seeing things. Rhythm is regular, so I'm not asking the second step. This was the second step, so your question is already answered. Second step, rhythm assessment, which is regular because RR is regular. Third step, a bit difficult. P, what are the four components of P waves? I'll come to everyone. This is interaction. We'll go with this rhythm. Don't behave in atrial. Be in sinus rhythm. Yeah, P wave? Present or absent? That's the first thing. Present? Similar or dissimilar? Similar. P rhythm? Regular. If you just assume that there is no QRS, you will found P to be regular. One before each QRS. There are one before each QRS. So all facets of P or component of P are normal here in this ECG. PR interval. So you think it's normal here. It's not less than 3 and it's not more than 5. QRS duration. This is again normal. So the conclusion is, अब मैं अक्सर ये बात कहता हूँ कि मेडिसिन में किसी भी चीज़ को असेस करने के बाद सबसे जो मुश्किल काम होता है ना वो ये कहना कि ये नॉर्मल है, isn't it? कोई मरीज़ आपको दिखाने आए और अब ये कहते हैं तुम्हें कुछ नहीं है, by just seeing, assessing, this is the most difficult thing to say, वरना कुछ ना कुछ पता नहीं एक्सरे में यार ये लग रहा है कोई और चीज़ देख रहे हैं ये चीज़ लग रही है पता नहीं नॉर्मल है नहीं है नॉर्मल सो एट लीस्ट नाउ यू कैन जज व्हाट इज नॉर्मल इजंट इट इफ यू लुक ऑल दीज फाइव कंपोनेंट्स एंड फाउंड रेट टू बी बिटवीन 60 एंड 100 आरआर टू बी रेगुलर पी वेव प्रेजेंट सिमिलर सेम रिदम विद वन पी बिफोर ईच क्यूआरएस विद अ पीआर ऑफ not less than 3 and not less than more than 5 and a narrow QRS, you can confidently say that this is, and that's enough for me. If you at least learn that this is sinus rhythm and this is non sinus rhythm, I feel I have achieved something, that at least you can say after seeing ECG that this is normal sinus or something. So that means you have to stick to these 5 points when you are assessing rhythm. And even apparently looking normal ECG, go through these 5 points. Then these will be your second nature. And you are going to assess these in seconds. Within 3-4 seconds you will look for these 5 things. Tuck, 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 tuck. And deviation from each individual component usually gives you an idea that what rhythm you are dealing with. So even assessing for normal and assessing for abnormal, ultimately you have to go through these 5 points. And that's the key of assessing rhythms. Let's quickly go through arrhythmias. You can go stepwise or you can give us conclusion and say that what is the different from the normal. Sinus tachycardia, very good. Why? What is the deviation from sinus rhythm? Rate. Everything is same that of normal sinus rhythm. The only rate is fast. So this is sinus tachycardia. So carefully look at everything. If everything is that of same of that sinus rhythm, just rate fast, then this is sinus tachycardia. If you have any problem, you can pass it on. But no, I can't tell. There is no compulsion. You think it's sinus tachycardia? No. Sinus tachycardia. Now go stepwise, rate fast. Okay? Around 180, 190. Rhythm, RR regular. Isn't it? No P waves. You can't label anything as a P because it's not fulfilling the criteria of P. QRS? SVT. Whatever thing happening is above ventricle. And this is tachycardia. So it's not arising from the node, but it's arising somewhere above the AV node because there isn't any P wave. And since it's regular, that's why it's supraventricular tachycardia. It's not atrial fibrillation because you can't have P waves in AF as well. But in AF, your RR will be? That's the AF. So just R regular or irregular, P absent. The regularity will make a difference that this is AF or SVT. This is atrial fibrillation and everything narrow. So just remember that everything moves around those 5 points. Rate, rhythm, P, PR, QRS duration. Flutter, why? Because P, more than one P between each RR. You see 4 P's in between RR. And that's the differentiation point, that there are multiple P waves at a regular rhythm. That is again important. And QRS narrow. So this is atrial flutter with 4:1 or 5:1 conduction. अब तक तो बड़ा सिंपल मामला चल रहा था. Now this is conceptual, whether you apply those 4 points or not. And let's see, let's compel yourself to those points. And I'll help you. Rate, try to assess rate. Just 6 second step, 1, 2, 3, 4, around 70-80. Okay, rhythm. Irregular. So what kind of irregularity is it? Regularly or irregularly? It's occasional irregular. If you see, just 2nd and 7th complex are slightly premature. Rest of the RR are regular. So this is occasional irregular rhythm, isn't it? If you see, these are all regular. This 7th one and the 2nd one is coming slightly premature, P, present, dissimilar. 2nd and 7th are different from the rest. P rhythm, again 7 and 2nd are coming slightly prematurely as compared to the rest of the P waves. PR interval, almost normal. Just 7 and 2nd, I have slightly close or short PR interval. And 1 P before each QRS. अब सब चीजें मैंने बता दी कि दो हाथ हैं, दो आंखें हैं, बाल हैं, सर हैं. APCs, isn't it? Atrial premature, coming before the expected sinus beat, with a P different from that of sinus and slightly premature. So again, I'm really consolidating that everything is there in those 5 points. And once you're habitual in assessing the ECG through those 5 points, and then you'll able to interpret what's happening, if any point wrong, what's the abnormality, then correlating an interpretation. Why? You don't have to answer, you have to go through those 5 points every time, irrespective of abnormality there or normal there. That's the important thing. ये अब एक सब लोग पांच दानों की तस्बीह खरीदें और फारे वक्त में क्या क्या करते रहेंगे? तीसरे दाने में मजीद चार वो सब दाने हो, ठीक है? तो ये अगले 10-15 दिन आप कर लेना ये तस्बीह इसकी, तो रिदम तो कहीं नहीं जाता आपसे. देन जस्ट व्हाट यू नीड टू सी ईसीजीज आफ्टरवर्ड. रेट 70-80, रिदम ओकेजनल इररेगुलर, पी प्रेजेंट एवरीवेयर एब्सेंट इन द लास्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स, पी आर नॉर्मल बट क्यू आर एस वाइड बिजार इन द लास्ट विच इज पीबीसी. नाउ दे आर पॉलीमॉर्फिक बिकॉज इन सेम स्ट्रिप दे आर टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्यू आर एस विच आर बिजार. सो दैट मीन्स द जनरेटिंग फोकस इज डिफरेंट because if they are similar they will be recorded in that particular lead in similar amplitude. ki agar lead ka uska positive hai like lead 2 hai aur koi pvc av node ke kareeb se nikalti hai aur apex ki taraf jati hai to wo lead 2 mein positive aayegi aur isi tarah lead 2 mein koi pvc nikli apex se node ki taraf to wo lead 2 mein negative aayegi. so different formation or amplitudes of pvcs in a single lead means there are different focuses. just give you some basic concept. normal conduction aapko pata hai, theek hai, ye hai wahi jo bus humne zikr kiya tha. ab kya hua hai ki badi der se musafir khade hue the, aise node se bus aayi nahi, wo av node pe aage shayad wahan mil jaye bus, wahan pe bhi nahi aayi aur niche utar gaye तो देखा कच्चे में एक बस खड़ी हुई थी. तो सब ने क्या किया, उसी को ड्राइवर को पकड़ा, रोड पे भी नहीं है वो, जंगलों में खड़ी हुई थी बस, सब उसी में बैठ गए बस में. अब जाहिर सी बात है वो जो कच्चे में बस चलेगी वो कैसे चलेगी, स्पीड स्लो हो जाएगी और जिस भी डायरेक्शन में जहां तक उसको रोड मिल जाए कि परकंजी को ढूंढना है ना अल्टीमेटली उसने, तो ये कच्चे में बस चलते हुए ये जाके तो वो जाहिर सी बात है उस रोड की डायरेक्शन कैसी बनेगी, वही बिजार. अब ये कोई रोड से तो नहीं आई ना कि बंडल ऑफ हिस होता और ये वाली हाईवे और ये वाली हाईवे वहां से जाती, ये बस चली है कच्चे से. तो दैट्स द पीवीसी जनरेटेड फ्रॉम अ फोकस पॉइंट विद इन द वेंटिकुलर सेल नॉट फॉलोइंग द कंडक्शन पाथवे बट दिस कंडक्शन इज गोइंग सेल टू सेल and ultimately found its way to the whole myocardium and depolarizes the ventricle as a net cardiac activity. and QRS complex totally dependent on from where is it originating and in which direction is it going. yahan se yahan ja rahi hai to QRS us tarike ka banega, wahan se yahan aa rahi hai to us tarike ka banega. ye concept hai PVC ka and that's why you got this kaccha bus service in this fashion. this is normal highway. not difficult but apply the steps. rate very fast, regular, no P, QRS broad, VT. so you have to apply a principle because these five principles help you in guiding what you are dealing with. जी अब यहाँ पे 5 स्टेप नहीं अप्लाई करते, यहाँ पे मरीज को जाके देखते हैं. अगर ये आप उसमें झगड़े में पड़ गए, डॉक्टर फवाद ने कहा था कि 5 स्टेप देखने हैं. दिस इज वेंट्रिकुलर फिब्रिलेशन नीड्स प्रॉम्प्ट एक्शन. व्हेनेवर यू आइडेंटिफाई दिस गो टू योर पेशेंट एंड कॉल फॉर हेल्प स्पेशली फॉर डिफिब्रिलेटर. द